Now that you understand the basics of JavaScript, I want to teach you about a cool way of using JavaScript, something we call object-oriented programming. But first, we need to understand why it's actually useful. So I put together a program that will be better once we make it more object-oriented. Now, it's a pretty cool program to start with. At the top, I have two variables that store simple object literals inside. Now, the object literal is the kind of object we learned about before, that we create with two curly braces, and then we put all these property names and values inside. So we have two of those object literal variables, and then down here we have this function drawWinston, which expects a single argument, and then it draws the argument, it draws an image based on the x and y properties of the object, and then a caption based on the nickname and age properties of that object. And now finally at the bottom, we call drawWinston on the teen and on the adult, and that's what makes it show up. Pretty cool. Now, if we go up here and we look at these object literals, notice something about them is that they're really similar looking. Both of them have the same sets of properties, and both of them can be used by the same drawWinston function. In fact, you know, if you think about this, they're really both describing a type of Winston, right? And we can think like maybe there's this kind of abstract type of Winston in the world, and every Winston has the same set of properties, like a nickname and an age and an X and a Y. And here, what we've done is we've just created two instances of a Winston to describe, you know, a particular Winston. So this is a teenage Winston and this is an adult Winston. But they're really both quite similar, and you know, there's a lot of things that are similar about them. And, you know, if you think about it, that's a lot the way the world works, too, is that we have kind of these abstract data types like humans and people, and then we're all just specific instances of those with our own little properties. Now, we can actually use object-oriented techniques in JavaScript so that these Winston variables are formal instances of a Winston object so that they know that they share these things in common. So to do that, the first thing we need to do is actually describe this abstract data type Winston. And so we'll do that by making a variable, because we'll store the data type in a variable. So var Winston, and we'll do capital W, because we always start our object types with a capital. And we'll set it equal to a function. And this function is a special function that we call constructor function, because this is what's going to get called every time we want to create a new Winston instance. So we want to create a teenage Winston, we'll call this function, or an adult Winston, we'll call this function. So that means that this function should take whatever arguments it needs to know about in order to, you know, make a full Winston. So in this case, it needs to know a nickname, an age, an X, and a Y. Now, once we receive those arguments, we need to do something with them. So we need to actually attach that information to the Winston object. So we'll use a new special keyword called this. And this will refer to the current object instance. So we'll say this.nickname. So it'll say, all right, the nickname property of this object is equal to whatever gets passed into the constructor function, okay? And this.age is equal to the age that gets passed in, this.x is equal to the x that gets passed in, and this.y equals the y that gets passed in. All right, so now we have this abstract data type called Winston, and it has a constructor function that we can use to create a new Winston. So let's try to use it. We're going to create Winston teen again, but this time we're going to say Winston teen equals, and instead of curly braces, we're going to say equals new Winston. So we're saying we're trying to create a new Winston instance. And then we're going to pass in the information that it needs. So Winston, 15, 20, 50. Okay? And then we can delete this old one because we don't need it anymore. All right? And now that's created a new Winston. And now we can say Winston adult equals new Winston. And of course his name is Mr. Winstalot, sweet name. And he's 30 and he's at 229 and 50. All right, and then we can delete this object literal. And ta-da, our code still works. So what we've done here is that we've said, okay, there's kind of this abstract type of data, which is this Winston, and we can create new Winston instances that have these properties that are unique to them, and we'll just remember those properties inside them. And remembering is really important. So, you know, inside here we have this.nickname, this.age. If we accidentally, you know, didn't have this.age, notice that now it says undefined. That's because down here, this drawWinston function, it expects whatever object you get passed in, it expects it to have an age property. And if we didn't say this.age, then it doesn't have an age property, okay? We passed it into the constructor function, but then we didn't do anything with it. We have to actually attach it to the object using this keyword. So we'll add this back. Now you might be thinking like, okay, sure, you got your code working and you're doing this fancy thing, but you know, all we've done is accomplished what we had before. But here's the cool thing. Now, all of our Winstons go through the same constructor function. So if we want to, we can actually change some things about the Winston, all the Winstons, just inside here. So maybe age, we actually want to say years old. We can just put that here. And now all of our Winstons say 15 years old, 30 years old, right? So they're taking the part that's unique about them, but then they also have things that are shared about them. And that's the really cool thing about object-oriented programming, is this idea that there's these kinds of objects in the world, and you can actually create instances of these objects, and there's some things that are similar about them, like they all have the same properties, but then there are things that are different, like, oh, this property is actually a different value than this other property, right? But then, you know, we can kind of, you know, do the same behavior with them, like call the same functions, and use them in similar ways. So that's some of the cool stuff about object-oriented programming, but as you're going to see, there's tons more too. So stay tuned.